take you home. Mary. I wanna feel this porcelain.
UC Santa Barbara's Ultimate Frisbee Team is a team with 6 national championships, the most in college ultimate history. All of those titles, however, coming before the new millennium. In the past 5 years, the Black Tide had not even qualified for the national tournament, let alone battle for a championship title. But this year, the Tide would open a new chapter. One committed to channeling the excellence of the past and laying the foundation for a bright future. Built on high energy and bent on winning at all costs, 2015 is going to be our year. This is a story about building and about persistence. A story about rewriting your history. This is an ultimate story, one about the Black Tide. This is where the season starts. It's fall 2014. Practice from 8:30 to 11 o'clock. With a large rookie class this year, these first practices are a time to learn and a time to tighten up the screws. While on Tuesdays and Thursdays, tryouts are ongoing. The vets and returning players from last year are already in the weight room on Mondays and Wednesdays. Every year, it seems like more and more kids are trying out for Ultimate, and that's a wonderful thing, but There's only so many spots on the roster. At core meetings, the captains and a few other veterans evaluate all of those who wish to be on the team. And after a couple of weeks, the cuts are administered.
Hunter Corbett, Brett Lussard, Adam Fisher, Sean Smith, Taylor Roberts, Will Turner, Kyle Rubin, Grant Novins. Is it Novins or Novins?
It's Novins.
Novins. Ian Ladner, Hawken Ellingbow, Jack Hamner, Alex Heinzen, Mike Sale, Nate Ransom, Brendan C., Matt D., Kieran B., Mitch S., Aiden H., Jordan L., Evan, Jeff, Arthur P., Michael L., Bailey W., Peter, and Adonai.
Being a part of Tide is being a part of something special. We really live by that. After every game, win or lose, the chant we yell is Black Tide Pride. So to inject some of that pride into our newcomers, we hold a private showing of the 2001 Tide documentary, I Bleed Black. And with that tradition comes another, the ceremonial distribution of jerseys. Real jerseys. Now this is official. And this room is the group of guys you'll be battling alongside for the next year. So the season is on its way, and tournaments are about to begin.
Up.
Let me grab two things.
Wait.
Day one on Saturday saw four matchups and four victories for the Black Tide. Cincinnati, Utah, Tulane, and a close 9-8 win over Cal in the night showcase game. But rolling into day two's Sunday morning matchup, the Tide was stopped in their tracks by a formidable ASU team in the quarterfinals, with ASU winning 13-11.
Although Tide played well and broke seed, something was left to be desired. And thus was the tale of the Santa Barbara invite sponsored by Savage Ultimate.
Oh, this is for the
They're super efficient in their fanging.
Woo! Look at those bad boys. Those are fucking wet.
It's like, first you look at it, it's like, that's a shirt. You look closer, it's a Black Tide shirt. That's
back at practice, even on weekends, this is the routine for improvement. What we do right, and what we do wrong. Right here is where we gotta fix it. And when we do, things really flow. Yeah, we got class, and we got jobs, and we've got a myriad of other commitments. But if you want to get better, you have to play all the time. This year, we really wanted to make a statement. So, when tourney time came around again, we were preparing ourselves to put it all on the line.
Thank you.
With a tight first victory at 10-9 over Grey Duck, Tide went on to hand out losses to Arizona, Vermont, Brown, and UCLA, effectively getting themselves into bracket play. Facing UGMO in quarters, Tide won 15-10, but in the next round, Tide would be defeated by Oregon Ego. Again, Santa Barbara would break seed, but ultimately fall short. However, those in the College Ultimate community could see that the Tide might once again be on the cusp of greatness. Sometimes when you're working so hard, you lose sight of things. Fortunate enough to be where we are, we try to throw in a beach practice when we can. With the coming of 2015, there's the SB invite in January, Pres Day in February, and in the next month of March, the prestigious Stanford invite. Now playing top-ranked teams, Santa Barbara would edge out a pair of one-point victories against Tufts and Carlton Cut, and face a loss to Washington, all of this in pool play. In bracket play, Tide would again claim a one-point victory in a dogfight against host team Stanford. But in quarters, a skilled Colorado squad would foil the Tide from advancing further. In their first consolation game, Tide would claim a victory over a higher-ranked Texas team. Although this win was also just by 1 point, the Tide had earned some moral victories that weekend, believing that we could contend with some of the bigger household names in College Ultimate.
Ah! Oh, good thing you got a dark shirt on.
Hey, do it for a minute.
He lost one of the odds.
What does he have to do? Go all the way home?
No, just to the other end of the hill.
Wow. Look how white his butt is.
You saying your white, your butt's less white?
I got dark hair on me, so from afar my butt will look darker.
A Black Tide spring break is always a good time. Bodies have been rested, and friendships have been strengthened. And at the end of it all, our team was ready. More than ever, for whatever was to come in this final run of tournaments. Sectionals was first. It began with the squids, and it would end with the squids. We came into sectionals ranked number one, but in the very first game of the tournament, we were upset 13-10.
Let's get that energy back up, Black. Let's go.
Let's go, Black!
Let's roll through the next couple games. 1, 2, 3,
Black fucking time!
Most other teams would have had the wind knocked out of them, but the Tide was no stranger to in-game adversity. So with energy remaining at a high level, we steamrolled our way to the finals. Santa Barbara would beat Cal Poly Pomona, USC, and Cal State Fullerton in pool play, all by 6 points or more. Three words.
Sunday, Sunday, Sunday. Now in the semifinals, Santa Barbara matched up against Cal Poly San Luis Obispo, and Tide handled Core 15-8. Seeing as how the Squids, who were seeded number 3 by the way, pulled off an upset against UCLA in the other semi, this set up a rematch with our rival. If you're an athlete, every game and every individual battle you find yourself in, you think you're gonna win. It's really that simple. And although we subscribe to that mindset, the reality of this tournament was that even if we didn't win at all, even if we only played decently, we still could have carved a path to regionals. But we were sectional champions, and that means higher seeding for regionals. And higher seeding, well, we like higher seeding. We were going in at number 2, and the number 1 team was Arizona State. Now, mind you, we hadn't forgotten about how Prime beat us about 4 months ago on our home turf at the Santa Barbara Invite. But, no matter what, no matter who we were going to play against, vets and rookies alike were fired up, confident in what we'd been building since the very start of the season.
it almost doesn't matter who we're playing. I like to think about it like that. You're coming out to play the game, the point that you're playing, you can break it down to even that level, all the way down to each point, that's the only thing you're focused on. You're only focusing on that game, and I don't care who it is, it doesn't matter. We're gonna play our game, and we're gonna be able to shut down any team that we face this weekend. We're keeping that black tide mentality.
Chrissy.
I'm about to get the SUVs, the van. We going to Sacramento. Let's go, Southwest.
I think the key is to stay positive and keep the energy up. So, you know, a lot of times we get in our heads or we get down on each other. But when we play best when we stay positive, when we stay happy. When we're having a good time, we play well. So it's easy to do when we get pull ahead, you know, when we score, when we get that first break upwind. But it's hard to do when we fall behind, and you know, it's inevitable that will happen. We can't expect that we just have the lead the entire time this weekend. So a true test to our team's character will be when we fall behind, and will we pick ourselves back up? Will we pick our teammates up? Show that we are the best team out there no matter what the scoreboard says.
Yeah.
And that's the question. Well, the past 5 years I've invested my life into this team. You know, this team means more to me than I can even explain. It's hard to understand if you're not part of this program, but you know, I've been here since 2011. I've seen this team go through some shit together, and you know, some good shit, some bad shit, but I've gone through some shit, and it's really, really taught me a lot about myself and about, you know, about the sport, and really just about life, just how to, you know, how to come together with a group of guys, all the same age. You know, you're just a bunch of kids in our 20s, but we come together and make something that's greater than each one of us. And this is our year to prove that we are the best, because I know we're the best team in the entire Southwest, and if we can show that this weekend, that's all I can ask for. We just have to prove it. We're right there.
Everything that's been written about us this year hasn't necessarily been a compliment. It's been just the fact that we fight, like we work. We fight like we're, like, bystanders don't know what the score is, because the whole entire time we're up, we're loud on the sideline, we're laying out on every point, we're just going hard, and I think that's something that I want to make sure that this team doesn't lose, and that I can be a part of that too. So I think that's my main thing. I just want to fight this whole weekend, no matter what the score is, up or down. If we're blowing out a team or if we're getting blown out, like, I just want to fight the whole weekend.
Yeah, after the big rain, for sure.
Yeah, there's so much space after the big rain.
Yeah, drop back a little bit and then do it.
I think he's going to do it.
Is he?
If he does it,
don't wait for him. Don't wait for him. Don't wait for him.
Blast off or back off, Will.
Go right now.
No,
double yellow.
Do it!
Yeah!
Oh!
What the fuck?
Why is it double yellow?
It doesn't matter.
What?
Oh my god.
Go, it's started. Gun it.
Goodness gracious.
Man, give the truck driver a wave. He was trying to be helpful.
Yeah.
Huh?
Or no?
Oh, shit.
I want to really be the most dominant player out on the field at any given point in time. That's on both sides of the disc, so throwing and you know, on offense, and then also on defense. I want to be able to make any play and be open every single chance that I get when I don't have the disc. And then throwing it, not trying to force anything, because I want to really try and keep my turnovers low, but really being able to put the disc wherever I want. I like that question. It's gonna be, the motto's gonna be, black tide is the only thing that matters. We're not worrying about who we're playing, it doesn't matter. You're only gonna be playing black tide ultimate, playing in the black tide system. And with that comes with black tide pride and actually confidence and a little bit of swagger. We have a great program and the most storied program in all of Ultimate, besides the Condors, I guess, and in college Ultimate at least. And that really should, you know, should be able to resonate with all of our players, and that mentality should be going. It should be going into the weekend and coming out of the weekend, finishing with that black tide pride swagger.
Is it rolling? Are we rolling?
We're rolling.
Are we rolling? Obviously, my number one goal is to win the region. I'm trying to go to nationals. I've wanted to go to nationals since I knew that Ultimate was a college sport. It's been my dream ever since. I think it was seventh grade, eighth grade. Nationals is the goal, the one and only goal. It has been from the start. It always will be. This is the best team I've been on in my 3 years by far. This is the highest ranked we've been going into regionals. I want this so bad, so bad. This is all I've been thinking about all week. I'm in class, I'm thinking about Frisbee. I'm laying in bed, I'm thinking about black tie. I wake up in the morning, I'm thinking about regionals. I'm thinking about the finals, I'm thinking about the first game. This is what my year revolves around now. From fall quarter in August, when we're just looking at the season, to it's now May. Black tie is my number one thought in my mind. Every day when I go to sleep, every day when I wake up, black tie, regionals, nationals.
So I think black tie has a tendency to play down to teams. You know, we get into this mindset second half that we are just going to ride it out. But for success, we really need to keep the intensity up top all weekend, even against the lesser teams. Like, I think if we come out really hot, we should roll on Saturday. And I really want to see that happen. I just so badly want the chance to go to Milwaukee, because Black Tide hasn't been to nationals in 5 years. We're such a storied program. We need to get back, you know, to what we used to be. Regain our top status in the nation. I think we can really do that this year. Really good shot. One bid, I think that bid is ours though. Coming in as a 2 seed, but I think we are definitely the strongest team in the Southwest.
Cliche, but leave everything on the field. I've done it twice. Losing a regional sucks. Your year's over. You're not gonna get to play with this set of guys ever again. And Ultimate might be 7-on-7, but it is so much more of a team sport than that. So just staying in every game, staying focused, being energetic are things every person, you know, player 1 through player 27 can do. So really just enjoy it for what it's worth. It's an experience, it's going to be a fun time, it's going to be frustrating time, but it's going to be a hell of a weekend. Just stay pumped. That's what we'll play for all year.
Before we start the warm-up, we have a little tradition for regionals. Got some of those box for you. Their jerseys. You know, not many people get to wear these jerseys. And when you look at this hanging on your wall, like 10 years from now, 20 years from now, you'll remember this day. So, you know, you don't get to wear this jersey very often. So when you do, play like a fucking champion. Play like you're part of the black fucking tide. Let's go!
There you go.
Thanks.
Day one's first matchup was against the Slugs. Santa Cruz proved to be a tougher opponent than expected and held the game incredibly close. In this opening game, both the Tide and the Slugs were a bit sloppy, but Santa Barbara would win 9-8, add another 1-point victory to the list. The next game was against Northern Arizona. There's not much to say about this game other than now the Tide was settled in with a win under our belt. The score of that game was 12-5 in favor of Santa Barbara. The third and final game of that day was a heated contest. The Dogs of Davis have always proven to be a good opponent, and this time was no different. As tensions were rising, the O-line made it 9-8. With the horn having gone off before, a solid D-line was sent out in the hopes of ending this game with a break.
Break in this game, but it was the last point. That's all we need, thanks to the offense.
By the way, Black Tide for a long time has been a team that's operated without a coach, but this year was different. When Bacon wasn't on our sideline doing a damn good job, he was on the field throwing dimes in the AUDL.
Defense, we had our opportunities. We did not convert on them. That's something we're going to have to improve tomorrow if we want to have a few more practices, okay? Let's get a cool down jog and do stretching, and we'll discuss some more stuff in our stretching circle. But let's take care of our bodies right now.
Yeah, Ty. Let's go.
Hey, Saturday means nothing.
This is over.
Saturday means nothing.
Hey, Black Tide pride to ourselves right now. We're only looking at tomorrow. Okay. 1, 2, 3.
Black Tide pride.
For all of your teammates, we've all been in the gym together, sweating, bleeding together, every week and practice, every fucking taking weekends out of your life and put it into this team. And now is the time to reap those rewards. Now is our time. Now this is our tournament. This is our region. You're playing not only for your teammates, but you're playing for yourself, and you're playing for Black Tide Pride. This is fucking our time right now. Let's fucking go, Black.
Let's go.
This is it right now.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Like Hunter said, this is the day you show them what it's like to play for the Black Tide.
Black tie,
Day 2 was serious business. The first matchup was against Slowcore, and we saw Cal Poly back at sectionals, where we won by 7 points. This time around, we handled them again 14-9. Now, the semis against Chico, that was a war. They had athleticism and personalities, which led to some friction against a Black Tide team of somewhat similar makeup. At the end of the shootout, we lived to fight another day. There was only one more game between us and Nationals.
this experience. And I'm really happy for them. It makes me happy seeing them so proud of what they've done and being able to celebrate it. For these guys, it's been a long time coming. And it, you know, the play over the level of play over the last, you know, 10, 15 plus years has improved so dramatically. I mean, the games just to get here were incredible. And, you know, for them to be able to get to this point and achieve it in the final against a very good Stanford team, it's just awesome. It's just fun to see it. It's fun to see how the games come along. It's fun to see how the Black Tide has come along.
Right.
And, you know, it's great to be a part of it and share it with my son. It's just really kind of neat to see. So, very happy day.
When we needed a fucking point, you guys pulled it together and you played the best offense, the best defense we could have ever asked for. You've got it inside to do great things. You've earned yourselves a few more practices this year. We'll give you Tuesday off. But Thursday night, we're going to get back to the grind. We're not going to go to Nationals and just be happy to be there. Let's go there and take some games. Let's go there and take some games. And to do that, we still got work to do. We can still improve. I'm fucking around, guys. That was awesome.
Black Tide Pride. Let's go, boys. We earned it.
Oh, no.
1, 2, 3.
Black Tide Pride!
All right, stick with me here because we ran into some trouble. There were different groups of people on different flights, and I'll come back to that in a second, but our car and another car arrived late to the airport. We were 6 minutes late to our check-in window, and because of this, we would miss our flight. This lady is explaining that to us.
This is the worst thing that could happen.
No, we could've got a car crash.
While we were freaking out, some of the team was already in Milwaukee since they traveled the prior day, some others were on the flight we just missed. So here's what happened. We waited for the next flight to Chicago, because we had to connect there in order to get to Milwaukee. But waiting on the rollover list is mighty risky. In fact, there were only 6 spots, and we had 9 people. The other 3 had to leave LAX, go to Long Beach, connect in Phoenix, and then made their way to Milwaukee. Okay, so the 6 of us get to Chicago, but now what? We missed our real connecting flight to Milwaukee because we missed our original flight out of Los Angeles. So we could play the rollover game, or maybe we could rent a car. But you can't rent a car when you're under 25. Luckily, the boy Jackhammer's parents flew to Chicago too and were then going to drive to Milwaukee for the tournament. They took Jack and 2 others, which lightened the load of the rollover list. Now 3 remain, myself included in that number. So we lucked out and got the next flight to Milwaukee. When we got there, we called Brett and Fish, who came to pick us up. In a moment, you'll see Bailey in the back of the car. He actually made it out of LAX on time, but he missed his connecting flight out of Chicago and got left behind. So he took a bus from Chicago to Milwaukee Airport and we found him there. At the end of the day, we made it to the hotel, and just in time.
Yeah, let's go.
This is the lobby.
Where's the lobby at?
We're in here.
It's a fairly major place.
I was trying to get a snap.
I see the wristband.
Exit the airport to go down to the shuttle, to like the roundabout.
He was supposed to get into the shuttle. So they offer free shuttle?
Yeah.
How
do you play defense on him when his beard is in your face?
What's that talk?
Hey guys, listen up real quick.
Alright guys, real quick. I got a couple more things just really quickly. Then we get out of here and go to bed.
Peter.
Be down here at 6 a.m. for breakfast. My name's like be here. We also got
that's not dressed, right?
We got this Spirit Award. that was just given out. And also, first Coach Bacon just won Southwest. Really proud of that. He worked really hard for it, and we're here, and so he obviously deserves it. Other thing is the Spirit Award. Our most spirited player is Taylor Roberts. Round of applause for it. I just want to have fun tomorrow. Like, and that this is gonna be like a once in a lifetime thing. This is my last season, last year of college, and I just want to have fun. So let's make sure we're doing that. Second, it's gonna be more fun when we're winning. So that's gonna be easier to have fun. So let's win.
Ourselves a good day, okay? Focus throwing along this goal line, and then we'll warm up.
Warm up in your blue and gold. If you have a jacket over it, that's fine.
So I took this ladder all the way up here onto this roof, and now this is where I'm filming from. That's the team down there.
Jeremy Hooker with a kick of the end zone. Eric O'Shan with a nice tailback to keep it in the field of play for the Monomers score. That's the final here on Field 1. University of Colorado, Mama Bird, 15. University of California, Santa Barbara, Black Tide, 12. Thanks, guys. Great game. Good luck for the rest of the weekend.
Well, it was a game we could have won, and that's what hurts the most. Here's something obvious. Starting the day off with a loss is a lot different than starting the day off with a win. Not just in a statistical way, but in a mental way. Even the most fiery and energetic teams feel dampened by defeat, and it's tough to keep your head up. We hoped the next game against UMass would be different. They were another team ranked in the top 10, and this was an opportunity to bounce back. Massachusetts defeated Cornell handedly in their first game of the day, 15-7. So, they would be coming into the next matchup against the Tide with a whole different mindset.
Turnovers. All that matters is getting it back. So let's make sure that we don't have those kind of letdowns tomorrow. Other than that, for the rest of the day, let's relax. Let's have fun. Let's enjoy being here. Let's remember how we got here, you know, as a team, enjoying each other's energy and commitment and passion for the sport and each other. So when we show up tomorrow morning, we're a different team. Bunch of winners, happy to be here, happy to play a game. Alright? Let's bring it in.
Let's go, Black.
Heinz and odds me to hold jump on. In the ground pond. And I decided that 1-1.
So we played one of the odds, we did 1-1, jumping in a pond. This is the pond.
What are we talking? Are we talking fully submerged or what?
Yep, fully submerged.
Oh my lord.
It looks like a sewer pipe.
Yeah, don't step on. Don't get locked, jaw.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Yeah,
it's too
take warm up seriously. Let's stay zoned in. Let's stay positive for each other. Let's have a good morning, okay? Take a few minutes to just get some water, get yourself mentally ready for the day ahead. Then we're gonna check in on this end zone cone. We're gonna play some Black Tide.
Yeah!
Yeah.
Go Black.
Yeah!
Yeah.
Yeah.
Today, we're gonna fucking win the freebie battle. That's it. Let's win the freebie battle. Let's go home winners, all right?
Let's go,
Black. Yeah.
Yeah.
Black.
Let's go, Black.
Let's go, Black. Let's go, Black. Let's go, Black. One, two, three.
Black Tide Pride!
Yeah! Oh,
so long. Dude, you guys crushed them. One of the dudes wearing pants.
To that point.
Kyle, so what's going on? I heard there's some big news here.
Adam Schefter just had a breaking report. UNC Wilmington ended up losing to UMass 15-9. Okay. That means that if Black Tide beats UNC Wilmington in our next game at 12:30, we are going to break quarters.
Let's go.
Winner go home.
Who's yeah. Adam Schefter?
Adam Schefter, bro.
Beautiful eyes.
Adam Schefter.
no, hey, no big, no big, no big.
Under, hey. Under, your D, Grant. Grant, flat.
I can play.
Yeah.
we set our goal and we made it, here. Results be a little bit different. A couple things just didn't go our way, especially in that last game. Wind shifted on us two or three times, and we had like an up. They just had a downwind, a point, and then all of a sudden the wind switched. Now we're having to whatever. So we had some unlucky things going against us. But I can't be unhappy. This team played their heart out. They played, left everything on the field. They can coach his ass off. The vets got to play a lot and played really well, the seniors. It was really hard seeing those guys crying at the end and whatnot, because they put student vets so fucking much into this sport. So much emotionally, so much physically. I go to bed just hurting. I play so much all through my cleats, my toes. Most disgusting thing I've ever seen. It's all so I was hungry when we got here. It's just we came a little bit short. A little bit younger team and whatnot, but it's tough, but if we set up these guys for good stepping stone for next year, for them to just come here and rush. Because I know these guys can do it. They're amazing. I've seen it over the years, but this year's group is the best group. Most amazing rookies. And they're all going to be coming back, I have no doubt. So hopefully we set them up for a good couple of years. I'll be watching these guys, hopefully coaching them. I'd be scared if I was one of these teams out there. If they look through brochures, our average age is so much younger, and we fell short with the throws today. I'm not really upset at all. I like winning because I like them and whatnot, but just good 4 years, college coming to close, but it's. Feels good. Feels like I accomplished something,
Mad sounds in your ears make you feel all right. They bring back to life. Mad sounds in your ears to make you get up and dance, to make you get up. Yeah, to make you get up. Wild nights run, but you cannot hide. Mad sounds in your ears and make you get up and dance, and make you get up all night long. It reappears and make you get up and dance, yeah, to make you get up.
It's black tide.